and I thought the movie was outrageous.
What do we want?
You see all these rock hard dicks standing in front of you, man? We need some sucking, and we need it now. And if you ain't got sucking, we'll take some sucking.
Didn't y'all hear the sign? We're fresh out of hoes. Aren't y'all married anyway?
Of course we married, man. Why you think we here? Look, I can't walk around like this all day. I'm working in school with kids. My dick is harder than slavery.
Yeah, cue that funky intro.
He's dynamite. So dynamite.
It's rare that this type of scenario presented itself in a post-80s and 90s world. Nowadays, how often do you hear about a movie spinning off into an animated series? I don't think I've heard of any movies doing that since Sam Raimi's Spider-Man spun off into MTV's Spider-Man animated series. Like Dynamite was in a unique position. The movie got a lot of positive reactions and, as mentioned before, a spin-off animated series set in a different continuity was in the works with a 10-minute pilot proving successful. Season 1 was greenlit. Black Dynamite and the gang deal with a new threat every week, with each episode being self-contained with only previous adventures only being referenced in future outings. Usually what the gang has to deal with is either a parody of a 70s TV show or movie, or a significant figure in the 70s like President Nixon, Mr. Rogers, or Michael Jackson. The first episode with Michael Jackson really caught me off guard with its surrealism. I wasn't expecting that. The first three episodes are really noteworthy and some of the best episodes of any animated TV show. Michael Jackson, the porn industry, and Richard Pryor.
I'm sorry, Michael. We all are.
Shut your ass, Joseph. These motherfuckers messed up on Soul Train. On Soul Train. Obviously, whooping the living shit out of these boys twice a day ain't working out.
Right out the gate, the show starts off very strong. Black Dynamite is a parody, much like some of the supporting characters are parodies, of black celebrities during the 1970s. Black Dynamite, for example, is a parody of Jim Kelly, the martial artist, a womanizing tough guy who isn't relatable in the slightest. Oddly, he's likable, much like his movie counterpart. He's not perfect, he jumps the gun sometimes, and as shown, he doesn't have a good sense of humor.
Tell me where Bill Cosby is, I'm a...
No, motherf***er, you need to check the jello pudding plant.
I already been to the pudding plant. So I said to the Chinaman, I threw that shit before I walked in the room.
Black Dynamite is a cool character. He may not have any emotional moments because he's just that manly, but he doesn't need to.
The pain is too much, cream corn. And a real man buries his pain so nobody can see it.
If you try to just numb yourself and push your memories away, it'll just get worse.
I know you think kicking somebody's ass in the dick is the answer to everything, Black Dynamite. And usually it is. But right now, you're just kicking your own ass in the dick. Sometimes you just gotta let it all out and look like a bitch. Works for me.
Cream corn, thank you. Why the f*** you got your arms out?
Never mind.
I mean, I thought we had a moment, but...
I'll be there in a minute. Forgot my, lawn jockey hat.
Cream Corn is a pimp, but not just any pimp. A pimp that keeps his hair conditioned for the ladies. Cream Corn is probably my favorite character of the four. He's a loyal friend, has some of the funniest scenes in the show, and is voiced by Tommy Davidson, whose work I enjoyed in Living Color and Proud Family. Sometimes he also takes one for the team.
They could just throw up inside my mouth.
Treat me like a stamp. Just lick me, stick me, and send me the f*** away.
You really do want to keep these kids, right?
Then f*** me now!
Honeybee!
Bullhorn is the one who delivers rhymes in these tough times. He's also a womanizer who smooth talks women with his words, and he may or may not be the most underdeveloped of the group. Honeybee is the caretaker of the orphans and is easily underappreciated by the group, which is a shame, but the group soon realizes. I will give credit to the writing staff as they didn't point out Honeybee had big boobs until the third episode.
Hey, baby, you remind me of my mama.
Oh, because I'm kind and nurturing.
No, bitch, because you got big titties and your sales good.
There had to have been a lot of restraint. It's arguably her most distinguishable feature from her character design. Well, other than the fact that she looks like Pam Grier.
Like Dynamite, that's got to be breaking some kind of copyright rules or something. This bitch looks just like me, except for them little titties.
The characters aren't deep. They don't have to be deep to be developed. These four are a lot of fun to watch with how they work off each other. There's great moments of writing and dialogue in this show, with most of them going to Black Dynamite and the villains. That Frog Curtis and that Bastard Curtis being the most memorable villains with some of the funnier dialogue.
Black Dynamite? The day wasn't there for that, Black Dynamite? Okay.
Can't forget about everything, that Frog Curtis. Leave land.
Never been smacked across your face by filthy frog.
I have. It ain't a good look, Black Dynamite.
Don't flinch. It ain't coming yet. It ain't coming yet. When it's coming, I let you know. And I'm not coming at you from one side. I'm coming at you from both sides, from up, from under. You ever have your face uppercutted by a frog dick? You trying to rope a dope like Ali? But it's too many dicks.
Mr. Rogers is surprisingly the best villain with some valid points.
How about I tell you in a song?
Sell you ass and sex, so bitch, I'm bussin' at 'em. Adults don't give up, so bitch, I'm bussin' at 'em. They'll get you hooked on smack, heroin, and cocaine. Then you'll sell your mama, or even suck a.
The performances shine for comedy value. JB Groove as that Frog Curtis and that Bastard Curtis are just a joy to watch. One thing I gotta give credit to is the impersonations. They're very spot on. Michael Jai White and Tommy Davidson work off each other really well, and are arguably the best when it's just the two of them with top-notch voice acting. When it comes to art style, I don't know if I should categorize it as an anime-esque art style or graffiti-esque art style with all the shading. It somewhat reminds me of a 70s art style with just a little bit more detail and shading. Whatever the case, I like the art. It's stylish. The animation was great in the first few episodes, with a consistent art and action being fully animated, for the most part. Then there's action stills, which is an aspect I always hated about animated shows from the late 2000s to the early 2010s. To compensate for action, they use these action stills in place of fully animating a punch or a hit. I always felt action stills were lazy and the animators were just cutting corners with this. It just doesn't do it for me, and it takes me out of the moment, and it cheapens the action. Action stills are what led me to be a nostalgia-tard for a while there, until I discovered the Boondocks. I got off subject there. I just really hate action stills. I know animation is expensive, and that's why it's a small little community. I just really don't like action stills. The soundtrack has a few parody songs of the very artists that are the topic of the episode. Other than that, the show uses music pieces from the movie, which I thought was passable. I've got one more negative aspect to talk about. Some episodes in season 1 didn't work for me, whether it was the comedy or the subject that they were parodying. Season 2 had better writing and overall was pretty strong. Season 3, it was canceled. Another good show canceled. What the fuck? How? Its reception is positive and the ratings were good. Of all the people to break the news of the cancellation, it was Carl Jones, former producer of the Boondocks and producer of Black Dynamite. He broke the news on social media.
Tell you is, you haven't filed income taxes for 8 years, you owe the IRS $60,000, and now they're going to f***ing kill you!
Is that what this is all about?
These motherfuckers can't be bargained with, they can't be reasoned with, they don't feel pity or remorse or fear, and they absolutely will not stop ever until you are dead or broke or in jail or both! Incoming!
What the hell? This is one of the many quality animated shows that got canceled after not just a short run, but two seasons. Spectacular Spider-Man, Young Justice, and Black Dynamite. All good to near perfect shows get canceled. And what do you leave me with? Ultimate Spider-Man, Teen Titans Go, all these other shitty shows. What the fuck happened to action cartoons? With that said, Michael Jai White, Carl Jones, cast and production team, you had a good run while it lasted. Black Dynamite gets a solid recommendation from me. The show may be gone along with numerous Adult Swim classics. However, there's a Black Dynamite 2 in the works. I'll be waiting. You best believe that. I'm Lino Mars of the MMCA Productions crew, and I'll see you next time.